It's a very first world problem, I am aware of that.
I think the jet lag's gone.
Oh my God, it's amazing.
I just gotta point out that I was close to $200 in coffee today.
Get on the bus!
Just arrived in Kuala Lumpur.
That's funny.
Been editing a video. As I stood up, someone came up to me and said, editing video with bad manners in it. And he's like, oh yeah, he's like, I know some of the guys. And, such a small world, isn't it? I don't know where he's gone now. I feel fairly rude because I just walked off. I didn't mean to. Anyway, Kuala Lumpur. After 25 minutes of running around trying to find a lounge. It's a very first world problem, I am aware of that.
Trying to go and get on the flight to Sydney. I think it's 6.5 hours. Be all right.
Next stop, Australia.
I was meant to go in 2016 as well, October 2016, but I broke my ankle. We don't mind you playing on stage with a broken ankle, but it was the airlines were like, no, you cannot fly to Australia with a broken ankle. So I didn't.
Tuesday night, midnight, I'm in Sydney, Australia. I've arrived, gonna go to sleep. Within 7 hours, gotta go to the airport with the tour manager who's here to pick up the rest of the boys. So I'm gonna go to sleep, see how I feel tomorrow. See you later.
So here we are, folks, in Australia at Sydney Airport. So I flew in yesterday, I flew in last night. Woke up really early, woke up jet lag. Great, fantastic. Other boys are flying in, they've landed now. And I'm coming to meet them. Tour manager out here. Great. He's really, really good at his job. So I'm very, very excited. You'll all meet Chucky very soon. So the last time I saw the boys was at Scarmouth Festival. Oh, this is the 50th get on the bus. The 50th.
Wow.
First get on the bus in Australia. It's been to a few countries, hasn't it? Get on the bus. I was just watching some people come through and I was just going to go up. Go, oh, welcome home. How are you doing? Just see what their reaction was. But I'm not. I know you'd like me to do that, but I'm not. Australia, Doug.
Australia, we're here.
Woo! Turbulence.
Too much turbulence.
I can do a lot of things, but I can't stop that. This is the 50th edition of Get on the Bus.
Oh, nice.
50th.
Oh, that's good.
50th edition of Get on the Bus.
No.
Yeah, can you believe that?
I haven't seen one.
I don't like it.
I
Chucky,
like it. You know.
I know. And this is Chucky, his first time on Get on the Bus.
What's up?
I think the jet lag's gone. Managed to go to sleep, get up. It's now Thursday, the 5th of October. The tour manager, Chucky, is taking me for coffee. And there's a surprise at the coffee shop. Come with me. I'm going to take this opportunity to say thank you very much for liking and subscribing. Building and building each time. So I feel very, very, it's very, 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 very lovely of you all that you watch it. So thank you very much. And share it, when you press share and stuff like that, it does mean a lot to me, so thank you very much. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. It's about here somewhere, isn't it?
This is Connor. Connor,
hello.
Say hello.
How are
when
you?
When did you first work with Bad Manners?
I first worked with Bad Manners back in 2012.
2011, actually.
Or was it?
New Year's Eve.
Going into 2012.
Ah, see? I got you on the technicality. Connor works for the airline Jetstar.
Yes, one, I certainly do.
One up from Ryanair, right?
I am addicted to coffee.
Chucky is taking us for coffee. Where are you taking us to?
We're going to Honor Coffee House, Sydney.
I've already looked it up. It looks absolutely amazing.
They have a wine menu of coffee. They have a menu that's a wine menu.
Amazing.
Multiple pages.
Perfect for get on the bus, get on the coffee, get the shakes. Let's go and see how much caffeine we can drink in an hour.
Oh. Let's do it. Right, bro.
Right, mate.
It's so weird, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm looking at it right now.
It's like a wine menu for coffee.
It's fucking mental.
Jack said it's like drinking again. Yeah.
Went out for lunch and spent £190.
I spent $250 in here. No joke. I spent $250 in here. Yeah. Five of these. All in different shots.
Five of the bullets.
Oh, five. Shit. He only wanted an instant coffee.
He's a big fan of Nescafe.
What an incredible place.
Absolutely.
You've ordered what? Five
different coffees. I've got a milk coffee, I've got an espresso, which is split into two different shots, so I've got hot and cold. I've got a batch brew, which I just got. Got a filter and something else. There was something else.
Well.
It would actually be cheaper
to take cocaine. Yeah. Connor, what have you gone for?
I haven't a clue.
What have you gone for, Jack?
I've gone for Costa Rican V60, and apparently it tastes like champagne.
I'm getting lots of deliciousness.
How different touring is now.
Yeah, but just saying how comparing the prices to the UK.
Yeah.
And it's so much cheaper here.
Yeah, like, so much
obviously
cheaper.
Obviously the special ones, but so for some of the best coffee in Australia, it's cheaper than going to a Costa machine at a Shell garage.
How many coffees do you two drink in a day?
I don't know, it could be between, like, fully drink or just taste, because we try all the...
Okay, fully drink.
I'd say around between 5 to 7.
5 to 7. How about yourself?
I spit everything out.
Right.
I spit it out because otherwise I get a bit drunk.
Yeah, nice.
Alcohol.
Yeah.
I would say maybe 1 in 12.
Right, okay. Nice.
Using nice fruity coffees like this one. Because of the geisha quality, it's gonna be very floral taste. What you have it's like a different taste than the other trees. So this is a coffee tree that knows as geisha. What we did is one shot we poured on top of a bourbon. It's a frozen compound that's inside. What's happening, because it's pouring on top of the bourbon, will bring a little bit more fruity flavors up.
Gotcha.
So we don't use it for the whole extraction, just 12 grams.
Seems a shame to drink it, yeah.
Yeah.
The way I should drink this, I mean, just in one hit, is a sort of sipping it.
Yeah, always make sure you stir the levels through with your spoon.
So stir it through.
Yeah, taste a bit more like rice, a bit more soft taste. This one is going to be a little bit more spicy.
Okay.
So try them both next to each other.
But same story, should I drink the whole thing or no, just sip? Sip. So stir and stir and sip.
Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you. Happy man?
Oh mate, what have I been drinking all these years?
Oh, a bit of that.
Drinking the two different sides of a cup. Yeah. Cups, different sides, trying everything. This is unbelievable. It's the best coffee that I've ever tasted, and the way it's all done, it's like going out for a wine tasting or something like that. They've absolutely nailed it, and it's so good to see Jack here. First time I've seen him since 5 years sober, so that's such a treat. I've got a question for you. How many coffees do you drink a day? We're doing whatever he just told us to do.
Just do whatever he tells you.
Yeah. Just worked out that I've never ever had an espresso. My God, it's amazing.
I just got to point out that I was close to $200 in coffee today.
Well, that's the way to do it.
Yeah.
Next time we'll do more, yeah? Chucky, thanks for taking us there, mate. Jack, good to see you, mate. Tomorrow night, you're going to come to the gig.
Yeah,
Fanboy.
Yeah, fanboy.
Yeah, you too, man. Yeah.
I'll see you there, all right? See you later, mate.
See you later.
Right.
I'm going to go for a walk.
Go for a walk. Shake your anxiety off. I'll see you tomorrow. We're all shaking now. We'll see you soon. We've got to go for a rehearsal. Thanks for watching. I've got to get on the bus.